Well, here we have the interactive whiteboard, known most commonly to educators as a smart board, with smart being the brand. What makes it interactive is that in the same way you can go on your desktop or laptop and utilize your applications on your computer, you can do the same thing with the board. So I can touch the board and get a response in the same way I would get response on my laptop. This interactive whiteboard comes with software which allows you to utilize it in any subject area, whether it be mathematics, English, biology, etc. In addition to that, you can use the interactive whiteboard with any program. A music program, for instance, so it doesn't necessarily have to be software that is tied with the board. It can be utilized with any program.
So what's this that you have?
This is a part of the notebook software gallery, and it's a template. And what we find is that students, because this is their world, everything is interactive, they prefer something like this. When we were at school, we did our tables by rote, 2 by 2 is 4, like that. But with this tiles, you can have your class set in, and you're prompting students, you know, with their 2x table, tell me what's 2x6.
So this software allows you to put together a lesson plan, per se?
Yes.
And then execute it?
And you can execute it. So it can be a full teaching lesson, or it can be done in terms of review. So you would have been teaching your students about the tables, and you can do a review after. And then when I tap here, the answer is automatically revealed, so it's instant feedback.
Yeah, definitely interactive. So in your experience as a teacher, how useful do you think this is?
I think it is a wonderful experience with working with the department for the last 2 years, training teachers in the use of the interactive whiteboard. They've become very excited because now, instead of having to try to create stuff, which is challenging, you now have an electronic format, which makes it more easier, and more persons can access it because you have a big board. You can present it to your class, and they can also come and interact. Well, if you're just sitting at your computer, I cannot see what another student is doing. I cannot see what my colleagues are doing unless I get up. But here, when the students come to the board, everyone can participate fully in the lesson.
So the teachers are excited, but what about the students?
I can honestly tell you that the students are excited. I'm outside of the classroom now, but in a setting like this, I see students come and they want to spend hours in here. Yeah. And we've had students passing through for the last 2 days, and they're very into this. And I mean, even though it's educational, but they're still here. If I ask students, stay and tell me your 2x table, they will probably say. But here, they're very eager to come into it.
Yeah.
Very eager.
Okay, so I'm here with Kim Weeks. She is a videographer and a like-minded technology enthusiast.
How we see technology helping the youth in the classroom? I have this vision and a passion for culture and cultural heritage. And growing up in an age where I used to play ring games, street games and stuff like that, nowadays kids are into technology and they forget all about the games in the street, learning to be leaders, learning how to the social behavior, learning to work with one another. And that is one of the things that was pertinent in this ring games. Mm-hmm. And I would really like to see some of these games turn into video games so that the kids would still have their passion for the technology, yet still not losing their cultural heritage, knowing what their parents played when they were young. You know, so I think that's an important part when it comes to technology and the youth.
I could definitely see taking some of the concepts of the older games and adapting them into a more modern gameplay style and having something very interesting.
Yes.
And not just to the younger age groups, but
and the folks, older folks as well, but give them a chance to reconnect with the games that they liked when they were younger, yet still spend time with their younger ones in playing these electronic games.
And such a product could be an exportable entity. One of my passions is definitely video game development and animation, and I'm here with Danny Fenty, who is a fellow animator and developer. And he does some work with the Ministry of Education. Danny, tell us a little bit what you do.
Well, currently I've done some work with them, and it has been the 10 Heroes, V10 Heroes. Yeah. Is an animation based on a 10-part segment. So we cover all of the national heroes of Barbados, and also we've done a video game. We've done a video game for them, a computer software which surrounds the intrusive visitor, which is basically about Hurricane Janet and how to prepare for hurricanes that may come to Barbados. It's an interactive game.
So what other projects are you working on? You got anything coming up that's really interesting?
Yes, we do. Actually, we've now started working on a series called the Kids Central series. This surrounds educational content in animated form and also using film and so on. And this helps to encourage children to see what's over there in Barbados, also to help them to learn more about general information, about math, about English, about general knowledge, about science. It's very, very, very helpful for them.
So is there any integration between what you're doing and the smart boards that we're seeing?
I really would like to get a piece of software for these smart boards, because I find it can be very, very helpful in terms of the classroom setting. Yeah. Especially using flash technology, we can use that to integrate an interface, or to develop an interface, that would help them to learn more, to keep them abreast of and connected to the content that the teacher would like to show them, using animation and so on.
Working in Flash as opposed to other software is a lot more difficult and requires a high level of skill. So it means he is a very talented individual and should be recognized as such. Just took a look at some thin clients here that HP is offering. It's a unique way that schools and businesses can utilize some power saving and some cost saving methods of getting computer terminals for their employees or students. You essentially have one PC hooked up to the multiple clients, and you could have power saving, whereas a PC would use 300 to 600 watts, one of these units only use 40. So in the long term, it pays for itself, and then they cost a fraction of what a full computer would cost. So it's definitely a good option for any large institution, business, or school.